standing instead of, let me see some known face. रशीद जी, आप मेरी आवाज सुन रहे हैं सर?
जी जी अल साहब, गुड मॉर्निंग, कैसे हैं?
गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग। आप काफी दिनों से चुप हैं, आप कुछ प्लीज अगले एक आधे मिनट में कुछ शेयर कीजिए अपनी फीलिंग कोच के बारे में, कुछ कोर्स के बारे में, क्या रिकमेंड कर सकते हैं आप और क्या चेंज कर सकते हैं अगले 10 दिनों में। और आपका भी धन्यवाद करता हूँ, आप भी काफी क्वेश्चन पूछ रहे हैं, अगले 30-40 सेकंड में आप अगर कुछ पर्ल्स ऑफ विजडम दे पाए हमें प्लीज।
थैंक यू। जिस तरह से ये आपका जो कोर्स है ये चल रहा है, ये बहुत ही अच्छा, मैंने देखा कि इसमें काफी लोग इंटरेस्ट के साथ जो है ये काम कर रहे हैं, और स्पेशली जो फीडबैक फॉर्म मैं कल उसको भर रहा था तो उसमें काफी अच्छी इन्फॉर्मेशन है। तो अगर ये सभी लोग अच्छी तरह से इन्फॉर्मेशन ये फॉर्म सबमिट करेंगे तो ये साइको भी हेल्प होगा, उन लोगों का सर्टिफिकेशन और फेंसिंग का नाम भी आगे बढ़ेगा। तो मैं उसके साथ साथ ये भी यही कह रहा हूँ कि जिस तरह से ये लॉकडाउन के पीरियड में ये आप लोगों ने फेंसिंग एसोसिएशन ऑफ इंडिया और स्पोर्ट्स अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया ने मिलकर ये इनिशिएटिव लिया है फेंसिंग के लिए, तो ये बहुत बड़ी बात है।
रशीद जी, आप एक अच्छे नेशनल चैंपियन रहे हैं, इंटरनेशनल प्लेयर रहे हैं, आप एक अच्छे कोच भी हैं, ऑल्दो नॉट एन एनआईएस क्वालिफाइड कोच, बट आपने भी काफी प्लेयर प्रोड्यूस किए हैं लाइक रुज्वल, नन्नू, विशाल थापर, श्रिया, ये सब बेसिकली आपके ही प्रोडक्ट हैं छोटूलाल सर के साथ मिलके, और आप इंटरनेशनल रेफरी भी हैं। आप तीन बताइए कि तीनों में से सबसे मुश्किल चीज क्या है और सबसे आसान चीज क्या है?
देखिए, जो मुझे लगता है कि तीनों ही अपनी अपनी जगह तो काफी उनकी इंपॉर्टेंस है, हर एक इंटरलेटेड है सारी चीजें, लेकिन अब क्योंकि मैं बीइंग ए पार्ट ऑफ रेफरी जो काम करता हूँ तो मुझे लगता है कि सबसे मुश्किल आपके लिए काम यही होता है कि आप किसी के लिए फेयर जजमेंट जो है वो नॉलेज के साथ दें। तो क्योंकि अल्टीमेटली जो है वो सब आपको रिजल्ट पे डिपेंड करता है कि आपके जो रिजल्ट्स हैं वो कैसे आते हैं, वो कंट्री के लिए हो, आपकी स्टेट के लिए हो। तो आज के डेट में मैं ये मानता हूँ कि भाई रेफरी पार्ट जो है वो बहुत ही एक मतलब मुश्किल काम है, जब आप फाइनल जैसे कॉम्पिटिशन्स में होते हैं तो ये काफी मुश्किल पार्ट है।
बहुत बहुत सही बोला रशीद जी आपने, कोचिंग और प्लेयर्स तो पूरा साल मदद मेहनत करते हैं, पर एक रेफरी डिसीजन से किसी भी बच्चे की मोटिवेशन खत्म हो सकती है। और आपको ये जान के बहुत, क्योंकि रेफरीज हैं जो वो अनफेयर जजमेंट नोइंगली या अननोइंगली देते हैं, पर मोस्टली मेरे हिसाब से वो अननोइंगली देते हैं। 7-8% जो खिलाड़ी हैं ऑल ओवर वर्ल्ड इन सभी स्पोर्ट्स में, वो रेफरी की अनफेयर जजमेंट के बाद डिमोटिवेट होके गेम छोड़ देते हैं। दिस इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द रिसर्च आई हैव कम अक्रॉस फ्यू डेज बैक। तो रशीद जी, थैंक यू वेरी मच, हम आपके पास फिर आएंगे। लोहित के साथ आप एक्सपर्ट पैनल पे होंगे आज हमारे साथ, तो कुछ क्वेश्चन आपको भी हम पूछने का मौका देंगे। मैंने थोड़ा आज सीक्वेंस चेंज किया है, जो हमारे एक्सपर्ट्स हैं जैसे आप हो गए, मोहित, अशोक जी, इनको एक एक मिनट दूंगा मैं एड ऑन करने के लिए, नॉट कॉन्ट्राडिक्ट बट टू एड ऑन। विल कम बैक टू रशीद जी, थैंक यू वेरी मच। लोहित जी, वी विल वेट अनदर 3 मिनट्स, आई वॉन्ट टू वेट बिकॉज अभी तक 150 के करीब बच्चे आए हैं, तब तक मैं किसी और को भी एक मौका देता हूँ बोलने का, वन हु हैज बीन पार्टिसिपेटिंग, एंड अगर वो चाहे तो इस सीक्वेंस में वो अपना क्वेश्चन भी पूछ सकते हैं किसी से, एनी ऑफ द एक्सपर्ट। मेरे पास अभी ओके, ये इनकी आवाज हमेशा खराब रहती है। राजीव गोल्डी, अगर आप मेरी आवाज को सुन रहे हैं तो अगले 1 मिनट में अपना ओपिनियन दें प्लीज।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
राजीव गोल्डी,
गुड मॉर्निंग सर। गुड मॉर्निंग सर,
प्लीज प्लीज 1 मिनट है आपके पास, बताइए कोर्स कैसा है, क्या कोई सजेशन या इम्प्रूवमेंट, आप खुद इंटरनेशनल रेफरी हैं, प्लीज बताइए।
मैं आप सबको बताना चाहूंगा कि पहले तो जो हमारा जो यहाँ पे फीडबैक है, जो मेरे अपने स्टूडेंट्स का, जो पेरेंट्स का है, इवन जिनको भी मैं मिला हूँ अभी तक, अब तक का बेस्ट, और मैंने अपनी फीडबैक दिया भी है ऑनलाइन, और सीरियसली एक कॉम्प्लीमेंट है हमारी फेंसिंग गेम के लिए, और जितने भी कोचेज हैं इंडिया के और जितने भी फेंसर्स हैं, वन ऑफ द मोस्ट डिसिप्लिन गेम, वन ऑफ द मोस्ट डिसिप्लिन कोचेज एंड वन ऑफ द मोस्ट डिसिप्लिन टेक्निकल ऑफिशियल्स, इस तरीके से सारे एक जैसे ही लगे। यहाँ तो लगा ही नहीं कौन बड़ा कौन छोटा, वी ऑल वर डिस्कसिंग इन सच ए वे कि वी वर लर्निंग फ्रॉम ईच अदर। ऑनेस्टली मैंने एक चीज देखी यहाँ पे जो मेरा पर्सनल ओपिनियन है, ऑल लाइक इंक्लूडिंग मी, आई वाज लर्निंग फ्रॉम फेंसर्स, आई हैव लर्नड फ्रॉम भवानी देवी, आई हैव लर्नड फ्रॉम सो मेनी फेंसर्स जिनको विक्रम जामवाल जी ने बुलवाया है, एंड इट इज वेरी गुड अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर ऑल फेंसर्स जो आ रहे हैं और एक एक मिनट बोल रहे हैं उनका वो जो एक मिनट है।
राजीव जी आप हमारे एक्सपर्ट पैनल पे हैं, हम आपको फिर बुलाएंगे, एक मिनट बोलने का चांस देंगे, प्लीज रिकलेक्ट योर थॉट। आई वांटेड टू टेक यू टू वन ऑफ द बडिंग फेंसर, आई कुड नॉट कनेक्ट फ्यू डेज बैक बिफोर लोहित, वी विल वेट फॉर 2 मिनट्स मोर, लेट अस हिट एटलीस्ट 200, वी हैव अराउंड 180, वी हैव गॉट अनदर बडिंग फेंसर, आई सॉ हर, आई ट्राइड गिव हर अ चांस अदर डे बट आई कुड नॉट, बट आई ट्राइड एंड गिव हर टुडे। दीपिका बोरा, Deepika Bora, how are you liking this course?
Yes,
you
sir.
Are enjoying it?
Sir,
you
yes, I'm really...
You are from the furthermost place of India, Tinsukia, and Arinab Banerjee bahut achi fencing chala rahe hain. Is course
yes, sir.
Ke baare mein, how you are enjoying it? Next 2 minutes, next 20 seconds, please.
Sir, I'm really, really enjoying the course. I'm learning many things from this thing, and even I didn't knew there were 9 parries, and it was very nice to know. Thank you.
आपको ऐसा, यू नो दैट आफ्टर दिस कोर्स यू विल बी एबल टू इम्प्रूव योर गेम एंड यू विल बी एबल टू हेल्प द जूनियर्स इन द क्लास, एंड
यस सर,
यू थिंक दैट इट हैज गिवन यू न्यू डायमेंशन ऑफ फेंसिंग बिकॉज हर कोई अलग तरीके से करता है, तो आप कुछ इसमें आपकी गेम में कुछ सुधार होगा?
सर बहुत कुछ होगा, मैं अभी नया नया टेक्निक स्टार्ट करूंगी, इससे मैंने बहुत कुछ सीखा है और बहुत हेल्प कर रहा है ये कोर्स क्लास।
Thank you very much, bache. Keep doing up and keep learning. And it is very heartening to row. Aap wo Team Sukhiya se humare saath connected hain. And fencing is going to the remotest of areas of India. Although Team Sukhiya is like a metro, I have been there. It's a wonderful place. Keep up and keep it up and keep rocking. Thank you, Lohit. We have reached around 100. I'll just give 2-3 minutes of that. Anthony ji, agar aap meri awaaz sun rahe hain, Anthony, wait, main aapko unmute karta hoon. Anthony, aap unmute nahi ho rahe. चलो अंथोनी, मैं आप, आई थिंक कोई प्रॉब्लम है आपके, मैं आपको बाद में मौका देता हूं, मैं तब तक किसी दूसरे के पास जाता हूं कि हमें 3-4 मिनट और वेट करना है। वी हैव रीच्ड अराउंड 100-200 जिन्होंने पहले नहीं बोला है। चिंचोंबा,
हाय
चिंचोंबा, हमारे एक बहुत अच्छे फेंसिंग के खिलाड़ी थे, नेशनल चैंपियन भी रहे हैं साइबर में। चिंचोंबा, आप अपना बच्चों को भी सिखा रहे हैं मणिपुर में, इस आप बड़े साइलेंट से रहते हैं, मोस्ट ऑफ द मणिपुरी हीरोज जो हमारे हैं, अगले 20 सेकंड में आप बताइए कि आपको इस लगता है इस कोर्स से कुछ फायदा हुआ है आपको अपने क्लब में, आपके बच्चों को कुछ जो डाउट्स थे वो क्लियर हुए हैं?
बहुत बहुत क्लियर हुए हैं। अभी हाल में अभी नया नया जो शुरू किया है इसके बारे में मैंने बताया बच्चों को, तो बच्चों ने बोला कि अभी इंडिया में क्या हो रहा है फेंसिंग में, तो मैंने बोला इंडिया में फेंसिंग बहुत इंप्रूव हो रहा है। अभी देखो जमाल, आप रशीद जो हमारे जो वर्ल्ड कप प्लेयर अभी कितना कोशिश कर रहे हैं, हमारे वो ऊपर वाले प्लेयर भी कर रहे हैं अभी, तो अभी ऐसा माहौल चलता रहेगा तो इंडिया तो बहुत ऊपर जाएगा अभी खुल के। अभी
अगर आप मुझे अगले 30-odd seconds में आप मुझे ये बताएं कि मणिपुर में कितने क्लब, मणिपुर एक ऐसी स्टेट है इंडिया में, यहाँ पे क्लब कल्चर है, स्टेट एसोसिएशन तो अपनी फेंसिंग सेंटर चलाती है, बहुत से इंटरनेशनल खिलाड़ी अपने रन देयर ओन क्लब्स, आपके हिसाब से कितने क्लब चल रहे हैं इसमें मणिपुर में?
क्लब तो मेरे ख्याल से 20-30 ऐसा तो चल रहा है, लेकिन ज्यादातर एकेडमी में खेल के क्लब से पार्टिसिपेट करता है, हमारे वहाँ क्लब में खेल के क्लब में पार्टिसिपेट नहीं करता। जैसे रंजीत की अकादमी है, रंजीत अकादमी के अंदर 10 ऐसा क्लब होगा, और जैसे हिंदुस्तान के आरसीसी में 10-11 ऐसा क्लब होगा, तो हमारे वहाँ क्लब में नहीं खेलता, एकेडमी में खेलता है, फिर उसको क्लब में जाके खेलना पड़ता है नाम
ग्रेट 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 मैं आपकी बात समझ गया चिंचुम्बा आप ये कहना चाहते हैं कि बेसिकली जो क्लब्स हैं वो बच्चे प्रोड्यूस करते हैं और बच्चे प्रोड्यूस जब कंपटीशन खेलना होता है दे गो टू द एकेडमी और एकेडमी में वो होता है सेम वे जैसे सारे स्कूल बच्चों को पढ़ाते हैं लेकिन जो उनका एनुअल एग्जामिनेशन होता है वो सेंट्रल बोर्ड के थ्रू होता है बट आई मस्ट कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट 20 से 25 क्लब होना और मणिपुर एक ऐसी स्टेट है जिसमें आई हैव पर्सनली सीन कि जो भी खिलाड़ी सक्सेसफुल हुआ है फेंसिंग में और उन्होंने इंटरनेशनल को जॉब मिली है तो वो ही ऑलवेज ट्राई टू गिव बैक टू द गेम बाय स्पॉन्सरिंग सम और ओपनिंग द क्लब्स एंड आई थिंक मणिपुर इज वन ऑफ द मेजर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटर इन द ग्रोथ ऑफ फेंसिंग इन इंडिया एंड दे वर ऑन डिक्लाइन सम टाइम बिकॉज ऑफ लॉट ऑफ चेंजेस बट आपके जूनियर और सीनियर फेंसर्स को देख के लगता है कि द गोल्डन एरा ऑफ मणिपुर इज अबाउट टू कम बैक बेस्ट ऑफ लक चिंचुम्बा लोहित आई हैव गॉट 2 मिनट्स मोर Krishan ji, if you can unmute Lohit before that, I give chance to somebody else also to speak and share. Basically, I am looking for the ex-international players. After that, I'll give chance to those who are coaching and contributing. There are many people who are unsung heroes. Now, I come to the Lohit. We have reached around 207. Give me 2 minutes. Krishan will unmute you, and I will not disturb you for 40 minutes as you told. After that, we will get into the questions session. इबोमचा सर आप चुपचाप बिना वीडियो लगाए रोज हमारा सेशन देखते हैं बच्चों को दिखाइए कि इबोमचा सर कौन है इबोमचा सर एक वो है खिलाड़ी है जिनको हम ये बोल सकते हैं कि उन्होंने सबसे ज्यादा फॉइल के प्लेयर निकाले हैं मणिपुर से आप साई के कोच हैं और सर आपकी कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन बड़ी ज्यादा आप रोल मॉडल है हमारे लिए प्लीज आप अगले I will give you 1 minute because जिस तरह का आपने काम किया है आप 20 सेकंड में नहीं उसको खत्म कर सकते आप हमारे लिए रोल मॉडल है अनसंग हीरो है इबोमचा सर 1 मिनट में बताइए कोर्स कैसा चल रहा है और मणिपुर में जो आपकी क्लब कल्चर है या आपके स्टूडेंट्स उनके बारे में बताइए ओवर टू यू
ओके मा गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू एंड भाई एंड साई मणिपुर में अच्छे चल रहे हैं बहुत क्लब है मणिपुर में मेरे का तो अलग है साइक सेंटर है इसका राजको भी है रंजित की भी है अलग अलग मेरा मॉडर्न फेंसिंग क्लब भी है मॉडर्न फेंसिंग एकेडमी है बहुत चले है इसमें इस प्रोग्राम में ऐसे चलेगा तो इंडिया में बहुत अब ऊपर आ जाएगा देखिए लॉकडाउन के दिनों में प्लेयरों में द्वारा कोचेस कंसर्न कोचेस से वीकली एंड मंथली ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम मंगाना चाहिए ऐसे करें तो
हाँ। मैं सभी कोचेस को ये बताना चाहता हूँ कि आपने फॉयल में मेरे हिसाब से इंडिया में सबसे ज्यादा नेशनल चैंपियन प्रोड्यूस किए हैं और इन कोचेस को ये जानना जरूरी है कि हमारे बीच आप जैसे रोल मॉडल भी हैं जो चुपचाप लगे हुए हैं विदाउट लाइमलाइट में आने के लिए एंड मैं ये फेंसिंग एसोसिएशन ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया की तरफ से धन्यवाद करता हूँ उनका आई थैंक देम कि दे गेव मी एन अपॉर्चुनिटी एज ए प्रोग्राम कोऑर्डिनेटर to introduce legends like you to the Indian fencing. Aaj Indian fencing agar kahin pe khadi hai, to usme aapka ek bahut bada yogdan hai. Please stay continue, stay safe. We will keep coming to you. You are one of the wonderful asset of country. Thank you very much, Ibomcha sir. Lohit, last speaker. After that, I hand over to you. I am just looking for one more international player, somebody who has logged in or somebody who was unsung hero. Let me see. Last, Lohit, just be prepared. I'll not take more than 20 seconds. Harpreet ji. Harpreet Singh Khasa, jo ek former national level player hain, achhe coach hain, nationals mein referee bhi karte hain, Delhi State Association ke secretary bhi hain. Inhone Fencing Association of India ke saath milke French Embassy se kuch memorandum kiya tha kuch saal pehle aur bahut achha camp lagaya tha Delhi mein. बहुत बढ़िया नेशनल्स करवाई इन्होंने अभी दो पिछले बैक टू बैक इंडिया में हरप्रीत जी अगले 20 सेकंड में मैं आपको बोलने का मौका देता हूं आप क्या अपने फीलिंग शेयर करना चाहते हैं स्कोर से रिलेटेड उसके आफ्टर दैट लोहित प्लीज टेक ओवर हरप्रीत सिंह खासा आई थिंक हरप्रीत इज नॉट एबल टू लिसन टू अस Harpreet Singh Khasa, you are there? Okay, I think we will get him in the second break. Lohit, I just want to have a word about the Lohit before he takes a class. Lohit is one of the silent operator who is working around the clock behind this success of this coach. He hails from Karnataka. His first love has always been foil. He has been a foil fencer of national and international repute, an amazing coach, and above all, one of the two people in India who has cleared all three events in FIB grade referee. One of the best minds we have in India as far as fencing is concerned in the upcoming generation. So best should always be kept for the last. So today's last technical lesson of fencing. So I told Lohit ki we'll deliberately get you at last. Lohit only requested me ki don't interrupt me for 40 minutes. After that you can interrupt and at the 10 minutes. It is going to be a wonderful session. Keep posting your questions on the WhatsApp community to me or during chat. And I was personally looking forward for this session because foil is very technical, especially jury in foil. Lohit, over to you. Next 40 minutes is yours. At 41st minute, I'll interrupt you as a good coordinator. Bye.
Thank you, Vikram sir. Well, good morning, everybody. I welcome you all to this refereeing and foil session. Well, first of all, I would like to thank Sports Authority of India and Fencing Association of India. I would like to thank our President Mehta sir and our Secretary General Bashir sir and Treasurer Dadare sir. And I also like to thank our State Secretary Prakash sir for giving me this opportunity. Well, going forward, well, I would like to recap on what Vikram sir said, that today is going to be the last session of mostly the Indian speakers, because from tomorrow onwards we're going to have a lot of foreign delegates who are going to come and share their experience, and they will be sharing their experience in English. So I thought I would also like to conduct this session in simple English, so that it is very important for you all to also understand most of the conventions are also explained in English. If you see at the international, two official languages are one is French and the other one is English. Well, it's been a very good so many days that we have had sessions. I see Vikram sir has been introducing all the speakers very generously. Well, I have to tell before going any further, I just like to tell. You must be knowing him as a national champion and international player. But if there is one thing that comes to my mind about him, is that he is the first person to introduce fencing at Army Sports Institute. You must be knowing when Army Sports Institute started, it had only 6 sports in it. And it was he who proposed and introduced fencing into it. And if I have to select somebody to present fencing, I think it will be him for now, because he's the best at selling fencing anywhere. So that's about Mr. Vikram. Since nobody got much time to talk about him, I thought I will take this time to talk about him and then move forward. So first and foremost, I would like to also thank our panel of speakers, Ashok sir, Mohit sir, Sagar sir, Krishan sir, Rashid sir, and Deepak sir, to have me along with them as a speaker in the panel, because all these people are very senior to me, and I have learned a lot of things from them. So I think it is really an honor for me to be in the same panel and be a speaker. So quickly moving on, so I would not like to waste much time on some of the things that Deepak sir and Rashid sir has already spoke about, because sometimes a few things are very common in refereeing, even though three different weapons are separate. But let me tell you that some of the aspects are similar, like moving on to the aspects of refereeing. So let's say this, most of this aspects of refereeing was covered by Deepak sir and Rashid sir. So this only tells what are the duties and responsibilities of a referee, what exactly is the duty and responsibility of a referee in a competition. So I want you to quickly go through this. These are very small points, and most of the points have been covered by Deepak sir and Rashid sir. So moving on, I would like to come to the most important thing. I thought there are few things which weren't covered because of the time that was given. Even today, I feel it is very little time that we have to cover an entire vast subject which is there. So I'm trying my best to give you the most important things according to me. So I might not be able to cover the entire thing, but I thought I must start with duties and responsibilities of coaches and fencers. In terms of what a referee expects from a coach and a fencer in a competition area, because a lot of time coaches and fencers complain about referees, but how a referee sees coaches and fencers and what are their duties and responsibility. So I would like to just talk about this to start with and then move on. So the first and foremost thing, before I go ahead, I would like to tell you there are two rules for referees. Number one is you need to follow these two rules if you have to be a referee. Number one is that you need to be neutral. You cannot represent anything. You are an individual, so you cannot favor anybody. So staying neutral is the number one rule. And number two rule is do not forget rule number one. So it is the only thing that you need to remember. So this is how I learned, and this is something that I can never forget being a referee. Okay, so moving on, coaches and fencers, duties and responsibilities. So being professional is the first and foremost thing that any coach or a fencer can do. So being professional is, if you are a coach, you have certain duties to be as a coach. So it is very important that you follow them. And as an athlete, as a fencer, you have certain rules and regulations in a competition area, which you need to follow. So that is basically following these instructions is basically being professionalism in a competition. So this is what a referee looks forward in a coach or a fencer. First and foremost, so I will start. I want you to imagine as though you are going to a competition. So I've designed this slides also in a way that you are preparing for a competition. You are going to a competition. How you need to prepare for the competition from the beginning. So first you start with, you reach the competition venue. I would personally suggest you reach the competition venue one day prior to your competition, because weapon control is very important. If you do not have the weapon control marks, you cannot fence in the competition area. Your weapon plays a vital role, especially in foil, because most of the time, my experience is that at competitions, I've seen people lose out on points, crucial points, because their weapon are not working. So your weapon and body wire, everything, your equipments need to be in place. So that is your first step, weapon control. So they'll have to pass your weapon and your fencing suits, everything. So coaches and fencer, it is a must that you go for weapon control, finish the formalities, and then move on. Next thing is in a competition early morning when there is a practice session, when there are lessons given, it is very important for a coach to have a coat jacket, a mask, hand gloves. So this is a minimum thing that a coach should have while giving lesson. In fact, if you do not have this, the referee or the competition director, if he sees you giving lesson without them, he can definitely come up to you and give you a warning too. So it is very important for a coach to have a lesson jacket if you're giving lesson with along with mask and hand gloves. And for a fencer, the minimum thing while taking a lesson that you need to have is a mask and a hand gloves. This is the most minimum thing that you need to have. And also, if you are fencing with other fencers, it is important that you are fencing in full costume. It is not that you can fence in shorts, or you can just fence without your underplast on. So it is very important, even while during a practice session before the competition, you need to be in a full costume. Fencers are practicing with each other. Okay, so moving on, let's say, how do you come approach the pist? So what are the things that you need to take along to approach the pist? So first thing is, for a fencer, when you are entering the pist, you need to have two weapons which are working and which has the weapon control mark. Two weapons is compulsory. You can have more than two. I would recommend for you to have more than two, but two is minimum. One mask is compulsory. hand gloves and two body wires is compulsory. So and apart from that, for foil you need to have two mask wire also. So these are some of the compulsory things that you need to carry to your to the pist. And moving on, so now you start with your pool bouts. So during pool bouts, it is a request from coaches that you leave your fences alone, because the rule says coaches cannot enter the arena or cannot be behind a fencer during the pool bouts. You are allowed only during the direct elimination and during team bouts. And during team bouts, it is not the entire, you know, your state team or the entire country team is behind you. It is only that the four fencers that are fencing and the team captain and the coach can be inside the team box. So there's a team box and there is a restricted area. So you'll have to be there. You cannot leave that. And if there is any objection, it is only the team captain in team bout who can you know, go for the objection. So we are done with the pool bouts, direct elimination and team bouts. So the other thing is that leaving the pist. So before I come to leaving the pist, I would like to add one more thing is that any referee who is refereeing the bout does not, you know, come up with a mindset that, you know, that I have to make this fencer, you know, lose this bout. So he does not, he never comes with that mindset. So you need to change that thinking. A lot of people have that thinking that referees, you know, are very strict and, you know, they try to take, you know, personal grudges and things like that. But I have to tell you, this is a professional environment. Referees, coaches and fencers are seen as professionals. So one suggestion is that as a fencer, I have felt that let's say if a referee does make a mistake, because he also comes from the same place, you know, as a fencer, as a coach and as a referee. So he does not have any intention to do anything, you know, intentionally. So if there is a mistake, when you actually you know, get involved in that and you become angry, I must tell you, your heart rate becomes higher. So when your heart rate becomes higher, usually when people are angry, your heart rate becomes high, and when your heart rate is high, your thinking capacity becomes low. So if you see, one of the banned substance in fencing is beta blockers. So beta blockers is something that reduces your heart rate, where, you know, your thinking capacity can increase. So my recommendation to fencer is that if there is a mistake by referee, let it go. You know, if it is something that you'll have to ask, you can ask conventions. You cannot tell him. So there is a difference between asking and telling. So it is your duty to ask what is the convention. So referee has to explain you what is the convention, but you cannot tell it is my attack, because the referee is standing right there to tell. So that actually comes clearly under, you know, casting doubt on the referee's decision. So I want you to be as calm as possible. And coaches, also, I request you to be very professional, because you are the face of the state that is coming and participating. So a lot of fences are, you are being a role model to them. So if you are being indisciplined, I think a lot of fences are looking up to you. So that is why I projected professionalism as one of the, you know, biggest thing that you need to follow for anybody, referee, coach and fencer, for a smooth fencing competition. So leaving the pist, one important thing is that you make sure that you check the pools. You need to check your victories and defeat your points and then sign. A lot of fencers just blindly sign and then they come back to us and then they say, okay, sir, there is a mistake. Mistakes do happen. So it is very, very important that before you leave the pist, this is one thing that I would like you all to, you know, I would like to recommend that you check your score sheets and see how many victories you have and what are the scores. And then if there's any change, right there, you change it before it goes into the software. Okay, so moving on. I would like to talk about some of the offenses. Most of the offenses have been covered by Deepak sir and Rashid sir. So I would just like to just quickly rush you through these offenses. So first thing is that a lot of people think of starting from first group, second group, and then the third group. So, but I would like to put across things that are most important. So the first thing is that what are the three things that can eliminate you from the competition? The most important thing. One, if you do not have name and nationality behind your fencing, you know, jacket or the electric jacket that you have. name and logo, and the name is very important. Starting, you know, this was under you know, the second group of offense before, where they used to give you red card and start the bout. But this has been approved in the recent FIA Congress in December 2019. So for the season 19 and 20 and going forward, this will be applicable. So if you do not have name and logo on your uniform, you will not be entertained to fence. You will be eliminated from the competition. And next is absence of name on the back due to change of non-conforming jacket. So let's say you are on the pitch, your jacket, you have one metallic jacket and you have your name on it. And by chance, it is not working. It has some problem. If you have to change, again, in that change also, your name and nationality should be on the director's jacket. You cannot just borrow someone else's and, you know, use that. So that is why I would like to recommend you to have two metallic jackets when you go for major international competitions, because it is very, very important. You cannot just get eliminated because you've gone all the way and you've trained only for this. So don't let these small things, you know, get elimination from you from the competition. And the other thing is very important. This has to be followed. Non-presentation when the referee calls. So before the pole bout, 10 minutes before, even any call is made, 10 minutes before, let's say your event is starting at 9 a.m., then your reporting time is 8:50 sharp. So 10 minutes before, you need to come to the pist with your full jacket pant, with your full kit, and then the referee checks your equipments. So if you are not present before the 10 minutes of the start of your event, you will be eliminated. So make sure you follow you know, these three things. Like I told you, you have invested that one complete year, and also a lot of training and a lot of dedication and things have gone into it. So don't let these three things, you know, eliminate you from the competition. All right, moving on. So the other thing that can eliminate you from the competition is that after the 10 minutes, let's say you'll have to report 10 minutes before your competition. And then, so when your event starts, let's say at 9 o'clock, I said 9 a.m. is your event. So 8:50, your reporting time before 10 minutes. So when your actual thing starts, if you're not present there at the first call, you will be given a yellow card and then you will be allowed to fence. Second call, again, you will start, they will give you red card, which means opponent gets 1 point, you're at a disadvantage. And third call, if you're not present, third call and you're eliminated from the competition. So remember to be on time. Fencing is a timing game, so I don't think this should be a problem. So moving on, next thing is I would like to talk about second group of offense. These five things does not give you warning. These five things directly gets you red card. So losing a point is very difficult, you know, for any fencer. So understand that these offenses gives you direct red card. For me, these, you know, when I was a fencer, these offenses, you know, would be in my mind. I understand there are a lot of offenses in the first group, but those first group gives you yellow card. But yellow card is just a warning. But let me tell you, the second group of offense is direct red card, which means you will be penalized. Opponent gets a point. So number one is use of non-sword arm. So whenever during the bout, you use your non-sword arm either to attack or to defend. So it will be a red card, a direct red card. And even if you have scored a touch, your touch will be annulled. The opponent will gain a point because of this red card. Okay, second thing is demanding a break for a claimed injury. Let's say you have claimed an injury. Let's say you say that you have a cramp in your thigh, and this injury will be justified only by the competition doctor. It cannot be justified by your personal doctor or anybody else. There will be a competition doctor who is assigned for this particular task. Only if he says that, yes, this injury is genuine, you get a break. But if you claim a break for the same injury, then you will be, you know, getting red card. Or, you know, if the doctor comes and says that there is no injury, so then again, you know, you have claimed, you know, break for an injury that it is an unjustified, you know, injury by the doctor. So even for this, you get a red card. So it is very important. And the time given for this is 5 minutes. Earlier it was 10 minutes. It has been changed to 5 minutes. And the third thing is that absence of weapon control mark. So I told you in the beginning that if you do not have a weapon control mark, it is going to be a serious problem. So if you do not have weapon control mark, it is a direct red card. irrespective it is on your weapon, mask, body wire, mask wire. Some of you think it is just the sword, but no, weapon control is complete thing. You should have the stamp even on your plastron. So everything is important. So make sure all your weapons are checked. And the fourth thing is deliberate hit, not on the opponent. So when it is during the bout, then it is okay. It is not deliberate. But if it is deliberately hit during the bout, outside the opponent's, not on the opponent, then it is again a red card. So that is the fourth one. And the fifth one and the last one is dangerous, violent and vindictive action. So if there is a dangerous action that is being performed by a fencer, even that leads to a red card, blowing the fencer with the guard. There are so many examples of this. So I'm sure all the fencers would know what dangerous fencing is. So I will quickly move on to the first group of offense. I would just quickly read these things, because this complete first group of offense was covered by Deepak sir and Rashid sir. So I just want to move on very quickly. I do not want to waste much time in explaining in detail these things. So the first thing, so these are first group, which means that you get, these are minor offenses, which means you will be getting a warning. First thing is that yellow card, which means a warning, and then same mistake, you keep repeating the same mistake, then second time you get a red card. So the first one is leaving the pist without the permission. Once you're on the pist, you cannot leave the pist without permission from the referee. And second thing is Korako to avoid being hit. And then turning back on the opponent. So during the bout, if you're turning back on the opponent, that is also an offense. Covering or substitution of valid target, that is very clearly explained, especially in foil and saber. If you are using your hand or mask, especially in foil, if you're using your hand and mask to cover the valid target area. Touching or taking hold of electrical equipment while you're fencing, if you are trying to touch your body wire, or if you're trying to touch the spool wire which is behind you, even that is an offense. Crossing lateral boundary of the pist to avoid being hit. So during the course of action, it is fine. But if you are crossing the lateral boundary, to avoid being hit, then that is again a first group of offense. Interruption of a bout without a valid reason. So you cannot just interrupt the bout without a valid reason. So let's say if you are fencing and if there is a hair that comes in front of your eyes, then that is a valid reason. You can say, you can just raise your hand, the referee says halt, and you can do that. But if there is no valid reason, then you will be penalized for it. Next, clothing, equipment not confirming the curve of the blade. So all these things have been clearly explained in the previous classes on how your weapon, what is the bend it has to have. These things, I will not waste much of time on this. The next thing is placing weapon on the conductive pist to straighten it. So of course, when you thrust an opponent, the weapon is bent in different shapes. So it is important for you to straighten it, but make sure you don't straighten it on the pist. It is outside the pist that you're supposed to do it. And especially at foil and IP, bending, dragging weapon point on the conductive pist. So you cannot drag the point on the pist. Next is refusal to obey the referee. So when the referee says something and you don't obey, let's say, for example, on guard to play Ale, and if you don't fence, so that is again refusal to obey the referee. When the referee says on guard, and if you're not in on guard, that is also refusal to obey referee. Hair not confirming the rules. People who have long hair, especially ladies, if you are coming to the pist with your hair outside a metallic jacket, then referee, will penalize you. But if it happens during the bout, then it is okay. Referee will say halt and ask you to put your hair back inside. So make sure that it is confirming and it is tied up well in the bout. Next is jostling, disorderly fencing, taking off the mask before the referee calls halt, dressing or undressing on the pist. So these are all something that you already know. Moving on, irregular movements on the pist, hits made with violence or during after falling. So this is so fencing has certain movements. So if you're doing some irregular movement on the pist, then that is again a first group of offense. Next thing is very important. This is something a lot of people don't know. Unjustified appeal, casting doubt on the decision of the referee on a point of fact. So this is what I was trying to tell you when I was talking in the first slide. So this also comes under the first group of offense. So make sure that you don't do an appeal which is unjustified and cast doubt on the decision of a referee, which is a point of fact. Okay. So next is entering the pitch enclosure without referee's permission. So it is very important that this is usually happens during the team bout. So I have also made a special thing that is annulment. So if you see in the rule book, with this offenses, you will see a small star, a small marking. Some of it have it, some of them don't have it. So this marking of the star means any hit scored at that fault, their hit will be annulled. So annulment of any hit scored by the fencer at fault, if there is a star that is marked on the offenses that you read on the rule book, that means that those hits will be annulled. So that is what the meaning of that star marking is. So it is very important for you to understand, it is right here, this star marking. So a lot of people miss out on this while reading the rule book. So I want you to go through this and check. Second thing is this plus symbol. This plus symbol that you can see here also when it says entering the pitch enclosure. So this completely means that this is a special yellow card, which is given for the team. Let's say if your team is entering the pitch enclosure, without the referee's permission, and the referee gives you a card, then the card is valid for the entire team. So every time there is a fault, first group of offense in the bout by any fencer in your team, we will give you red cards. We will immediately go to the second group of offense. So that is what the card means. Okay, so moving on next. So this is where we start with our convention part. I'm almost done with, what are the common things. So now is the most interesting thing is the convention part. So I would like you all to read this, and I'm going to read this and explain. This is an article that I found on the internet. This was way back written on the 1957 Amateurs Fencers League of America in the rule book. Because what I see is the problem is a lot of people misinterpret what is written in the rule book in terms of what is attack and what is a right of way. So here the rule, does not require that the attack be made with a fully extended arm. In fact, there are outstanding international champions in foil and sabre who attack without extending the arm fully. However, in all cases, the attacker must clearly take initiative in combat by threatening the defender's target with a forward movement of the weapon. So it is a very important thing, and it is a beautiful message given here. I'm sure you will all agree, foil players and sabre players, that all the hits cannot be made by just extending the arm. So whether by extension of the arm or a movement of the body or a combination of these, so it has to be of these. So the right of way starts here when there is a forward movement and when there is a threatening to the opponent. So that itself is considered to be right of way. So the classical schools, however, of fencing recommend the extension of the arm on the attack because this method simplifies the task of president of the jury in many situations. So they recommend you this because it is a very clear action. For an attacker, it is very clearly seen for a referee if you are performing the extension of the arm and finishing. This reminds me of one beautiful video that I saw. I'm sure you must be knowing about Vasil Milenshi. He is one of the best saber referee. In fact, even Papa Touré, who came the other day on our class, who's an A-grade certified referee, he considered him as one of the best referee in today's saber refereeing. He told that foil and saber are like an artist performing on the pist. So all the spectators are the audience who are watching, and the referee is also one of them who is watching you. So the more better you perform your actions, the better, the more clarity that the referee gets. So that is why it is very important that you perform your attacking actions, your right of way very clearly, so that the referee sees it. Because even if there is an attack from both the end and one of them has, let's say, a counter action, then the referee will clearly go for somebody which he sees clearly as an attacking action. So foul and cyber offenses, make sure that any action that you perform that is very clear to the referee as well as everybody who's watching you. So that is how it is. Moving on, I have made certain situations, the most obvious situations in foil. So I'm going to talk about these situations, even though I'm not going to explain the exact, let's say, definition of this, because most of this attacks and you know, defensive actions definitions were clearly covered by the other speakers. So I would just like to, you know, convey the convention part.
Lohit, I just want to interrupt you. How many slides you have left, basically?
There are another 18 slides, 18 to 19 slides.
Okay, how much time it will take, you think?
Every slide will take about 2 to 3 minutes.
No, that means 18, you have got 30 minutes. My request is you, now after 40 minutes, I recommend that we should take 5 to 7 minutes break so that yes. Otherwise it will become monotonous. What yes. do you say?
Yes. I'm going to
will take
this convention you, part and then moving
okay,
on.
Okay, just tell me another 5 minutes we need to take break. Otherwise it will become kind of into the boring zone. You understand?
Okay. All right.
It's submission. So, you just take another 5 minutes, we'll take a break.
All right. So starting with the conventions, first one, the most common thing is attack simultaneous. Both defenses start the attack at the same time, open their hand, finish at the same time. This is attack simultaneous. There are questions being asked, sir, if there is an opponent who's opening the hand first and then an opponent taking a step forward first, who has more advantage? But let me tell you, there are two ways of looking at it. One is that the 4 meters that you are standing, when a referee says on guard to play in the 4 meters, if a fencer starts the arm action before a fencer takes any moment, then fencer who opens the hand has the right of way because of the extension of arm. And if it is at the same time, and if both finish at the same time, then it is attack simultaneous. So this is something that you need to be very clear about. Moving on, attack, counter attack. So the attack clearly says that either you start with your hand first and finish, or you gain the right of way. Gaining the right of way means you are taking that initial moment to gain the right of way before opponent does anything. So if you take a step forward and you keep moving forward and you do not make any stops in between, and then the person who's moving back does extension of arm and does a lunge. But still, if there are two lamps that is coming up, I think the attacker will definitely have an advantage if there is no pause. So that is why, when you move forward, you need to make sure that you do not stop in between. When attack is completely, that is continued with your right of way. Okay, so that is basically attack and counterattack. So fencer A starts, he becomes the attacker, and somebody who's doing an attack on the attack is considered to be counterattack. Next thing is a very important thing. A lot of people have a misunderstanding on attack on preparation. I hear people tell, sir, what is preparation attack? But let me clarify this. There's nothing called preparation attack. There can only be something like attack on preparation. So if there is a fencer who's preparing, there was, in the previous class, Ashok sir clearly explained preparation can be from the leg or from the hand, or it can be both. So if an attack can be on the preparation, but it cannot be a preparation attack. So if there is a fencer who's starting, that means that fencer has the right of way, unless and until that fencer stops or has the intention to hold your weapon. So one fencing time plays a crucial role in this. Also, because if there is a fencer moving forward and does not execute the attack properly and is still on preparation, then the person who does a counter attack gets a point. So it is basically not considered as counter attack. It is considered to be a clear attack from the other end. So that is attack on the preparation of the fencer. So make this concept very clear that there is nothing called attack preparation. Preparation attack, I'm sorry. So there is only something called as attack on the preparation of a fencer. Okay, so moving on, attack, no, counter attack. So this is very clear that when a fencer attacks, and if there is no hit registered on the apparatus, no hit as in not even the white line, so that is considered to be attack no, and then the opponent gets a point, which is a counter attack. The other situation is that attack premier no. So the word premier means first. So when a referee says attack premier no, it means that attack first time no. So this is a situation where an attacker has opened his hand, opened his hand and again, opened his hand. So it has happened twice. So the first time when he opened the hand, he could not finish the attack. So he was on preparation. So the second time again, he thrusts. So when there are two lamps, then the counter attacker has the right of way, because any action that is performed in an attack has to be in one fencing time. And if you do not perform in one fencing time, it becomes premier no. Irrespective of you hit the target, you don't hit the target. So make sure that you hit it in one single action. So single action is very important. Next, moving on is peri riposte. When an opponent attacks and let's say fencer A attacks and fencer B deflects the opponent's attacker's weapon and thrusts, and both land come at the same time, it is still considered to be the priority changes, the right of way changes to fencer B. So peri riposte gives the right of way, change of right of way to the fencer who's at defense. So fencer who's at defense have peri riposte and counter peri riposte, stop hit. So these are the these are the things that they have as a right of way to transfer the right of way from the attacking fencer. So this is very important that a fencer at defense has to perform. He has to make sure that the right of way changes from fencer A to the fencer who's defending. So peri riposte and counter peri riposte are one of the defensive actions which gives you the right of way as a defender. Moving on, this is peri riposte no and or premier no. This is another situation where when the priority, when the right of way changes, let's say an attacker is attacking and he does a lunge and fencer B does a peri. If the riposte is no, if there is no lamp and if there is a remise touche, then the fencer with remise gets a point. And there is another situation similar to the attack premier no, is that when you also do a peri, you have the right of way. Ensure that you thrust in one single action, even if you have if there is a compound attack, make sure that it happens in one fencing time before the opponent does a remise attack. So it is very important for fencers who are in defense for you to understand when the right of way changes when you do a peri and then the opponent does a remise. So he has the advantage at that time. Okay, so moving on.
Lloyd, we need to take a break. We are now 41 seconds. I promised you 40. I gave you 41. We'll take 5 minutes of break. We have a lot of important people signing in. You also take a glass of water and let people also get this knowledge sink in. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my constant endeavor to get you to the people. Lohit, I would request if you can mute yourself for some time. No, मैंने हमेशा से कोशिश की है कि जब से प्रोग्राम शुरू हुआ है कि मैं आपको कुछ ऐसे लोगों से मिलाऊं जिन्होंने फेंसिंग के लिए बहुत कंट्रीब्यूट किया है और आज भी वो बहुत कंट्रीब्यूट कर रहे हैं. एक बड़ी अच्छी कहावत है व्यक्ति विशेष या एरिया विशेष. स्पेशलाइज टू पे पर्सन, पर्सन स्पेसिफिक और एरिया स्पेसिफिक. हमारी कंट्री में बहुत सी ऐसी लोकेशंस है यहाँ पे फेंसिंग लगातार डेवलप हुई, उसने बहुत से रोल मॉडल्स प्रोड्यूस किए, नेशनल चैंपियंस प्रोड्यूस किए, 10-12 पॉकेट्स हैं. ये ऐसी पॉकेट्स हैं जो आज तक बड़े, दे आर साइलेंट वर्कर, चुपचाप काम करते रहे. कभी इनको ऊपर इन्होंने आने की ना चेष्टा की ना मंशा थी. दीज आर द पीपल, यहाँ से ग्रास रूट लेवल में फेंसिंग बहुत डेवलप हुई. उन्हीं एरियाज में एक एरिया जो मैं आज आपको मेंशन करने वाला हूं, ये है फतेहगढ़ डिस्ट्रिक्ट है पंजाब में. वहां पे एक छोटा सा गांव है खुमानो. खुमानो को मैं पंजाब का करतारपुर फेंसिंग कहता हूं. खुमानो जैसे करतारपुर जो जगह थी, करतारपुर इज द प्लेस वेयर इज हॉकी, इट इज कॉल्ड मदर ऑफ हॉकी. वहां से बहुत से ओलंपियंस को प्रोड्यूस किया गया. जो फेंसिंग का करतारपुर है पंजाब में, वो है मेरे हिसाब से खुमानो. हुमानो ने इतने ज्यादा नेशनल चैंपियन और वंडरफुल कोचेस प्रोड्यूस किए, करमजीत से आप मिले, वी हैव भूपिंदर, मनप्रीत, नंबर ऑफ देम। एक मेरा बहुत पुराना कुलीग और फ्रेंड, इसका नाम हरप्रीत सिंह भट्टी, ये 2004-5 तक साइबर खेलते थे, इप्पी खेलते थे, इंटरनेशनल खिलाड़ी हैं, आपकी व्यू फॉइल में है। 2004 के आसपास इनको साइबर खेलते खेलते एक बड़ी इंजरी हुई थी, जिसकी वजह से इनका ACL टीयर डैमेज हो गया था, ये फेंसिंग परस्यू नहीं कर पाए। तो उसके बाद हरप्रीत ने मूवी फिल्म मेकिंग, ही वेंट टूवर्ड्स द फिल्म मेकिंग एंड ही इज वन ऑफ द रिनाउंड डायरेक्टर्स ऑफ पंजाब फिल्म इंडस्ट्री। ही हैज मेड 4-5 फिल्म्स, आउट ऑफ दैट वन ऑफ द बेस्ट वंस आई सी सॉ रिसेंटली इज रब द रेडियो। Harpreet Singh has been awarded as a best debut director of Punjab two years back, and it is my privilege to introduce to you Harpreet Singh Bhatti, जो national champion भी रहे हैं। और मैंने इनको बुलाया और ये बोला कि आप fencing की projection के लिए documentary बनाएंगे, जो ये agree कर गए हैं। Harpreet, welcome है आपका भाई जी, and अगले एक मिनट में आप please अपने experience share कीजिए, practice कीजिए, और आप fencing के लिए क्या करना चाहेंगे आगे उसके लिए। Over to you, Harpreet.
Thank you, Veer. Thank you, Background Bhaiya. Thank you so much, आप हमारे senior हैं. Thank you so much, आपने यहाँ मुझे ले गया है आप. इतनी मुझे excitement कभी फिल्म की नहीं होती जितनी आज यहाँ पे आने की excitement है. Thank you so much, भाई. So ये हमारे senior अमेर है, हमारा साथ देते हैं. मुझे पता नहीं मैं क्यों आया हूँ, लेकिन इन्होंने मुझे कॉल की भाई, मुझे बहुत ज्यादा खुशी हुई। थैंक यू सो मच अगेन यार, थैंक यू विक्रम भाई।
आप तो बहुत सेलिब्रिटी हैं, अभी आप मूवीज भी बना रहे हैं, और हम एज ए हमारे दिल में पहला प्यार तो हमेशा फेंसिंग के लिए रहा है, तो मेरा आपसे रिक्वेस्ट है कि आप फेंसिंग के लिए कुछ पक्का बनाए आगे।
सर मैंने पहले ही मैंने बहुत बार ये सोचा था, मैंने स्पोर्ट्स पे कुछ वीडियो भी बनाई है, लेकिन फेंसिंग पे नहीं बनाई थी। तो अभी मैं चाहता हूँ कि फेंसिंग एसोसिएशन है जो मोहित सर, प्लीज थैंक यू, मोहित सर को भी बेनती है कि साथ दो, हम एक डॉक्यूमेंट्री बनाते हैं, जितने प्लेयर आज तक आए हैं, जितने भी इवेंट हुए हैं, उस पर एक अच्छा काम करते हैं मिलके, तो मुझे मौका मिलेगा फेंसिंग के लिए कुछ करने का बाद में भी, क्योंकि मुझे भी अब भी जब मैं खेलना शुरू किया था ना सर, विक्रम भाई आपको भी होता था, मैच होता था, मैच था कल, तो रात को नींद नहीं आती है।
Absolutely, बिल्कुल सही,
नहीं आती ना, एक्साइटमेंट रहती थी
बिल्कुल।
तो आज की वही सेम मेरे लिए, आज भी मुझे फेंसिंग के सपने आते हैं, आज भी मैं रात को खेलता हूँ, तो मुझे लगता है मेरा कुछ अधूरा है जो मैं पूरा नहीं कर पाया फेंसिंग में, शायद मुझे इसलिए सपने आते हैं।
हरप्रीत जी, मैं भी बहुत चलाक हूँ, मैं सिर्फ उन्हीं लोगों को मौका देता हूँ मुझे जो पता है, जो फेंसिंग के लिए आगे कुछ कर सकते हैं। आप एक रिनाउंड डायरेक्टर हैं पंजाब फिल्म इंडस्ट्री के, और मैं अभी आपको हमारे जो साई में हैं जो लोग हैं, हमारे फेंसिंग एसोसिएशन ऑफ इंडिया में राजीव मेहता और बशीर अहमद खान से मिलवाऊंगा, और हम पक्का डॉक्यूमेंट्री बनाएंगे। हरप्रीत प्लीज स्टे इन टच, इट इज सच ए प्रिविलेज ब्रदर, आपसे बात हुई और अंदर का फेंसर जाग गया जब हम खेलते थे आज। थैंक यू वेरी मच,
थैंक यू बड़ी,
थैंक यू। नाउ मैं आपको कुछ एक बंदों के नाम बताना चाहता हूँ जिन्होंने फेंसिंग के लिए किया काफी। कृष्ण जी, डू वी हैव मेगलम्बा ऑन स्क्रीन?
नो सर, आई कांट फाइंड हिम, आई थिंक ही इज यूजिंग सम अदर नेम।
मेगलम्बा भाई, इफ यू आर देयर तो आप प्लीज हाथ खड़ा कीजिए। उससे पहले मैं कुछ एक प्लेयरों को चांस दूंगा, उसके बाद लोहित, आई विल कम टू द क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन इन एंड ओनली। I will get you to just wait. There, no, so many of coaches are there, but I'll give some to. Okay, Ashok, Sonia, Dr. Shahid. I have got with me. मुझे कल एक बहुत अच्छा पर्सनल मैसेज आया from Nepal. I will not name the fencer. Nepal से fencer said कि sir, I run my own academy in one particular area of Nepal. I was trying my best, but I could not teach the way I want. After this Zoom session and all the classes taken by instructor, I am completely motivated to take my fencing to another level. Thank you very much, friendly countries from like Nepal can give us chance. So I will get you to, I have selected few people. Rajeshwar, just check, Meghlamba is there? If you, hello, Rajeshwar, Meghlamba is there?
No, I think he is not there.
Okay, no, हमारे पास छोटूलाल सर हैं। छोटूलाल सर, you are there?
छोटवाल सर आपका म्यूट नहीं हो पा रहा है, आई थिंक देयर सम सेटिंग प्रॉब्लम्स, तो आई विल गिव चांस टू जस्ट ए मिनट, देयर सो मेनी पीपल देयर, आई विल कम टू यू ऑल ऑफ यू, आई विल गिव यू चांस इन द लैंड, आई एम जस्ट लुकिंग फॉर सम कोचेस हु कैन गिव अस सम गुड टिप्स व्हाट दे आर लर्निंग. Ajay Krish, Dr. Shah, hey Sonia. Okay, I think we don't have, we will give chance to somebody who's budding. Bhim Singh ji, aap wahan pe hain. Bhim Singh ji, 20 second mein aapko, aap kahan ke rehne wale hain? Kya fencing se aapko kuch fayda hua? Please bataiye.
Sir, good morning sir.
Haan ji, kahan ke rehne wale hain?
I am from Hyderabad.
Haan ji, great.
Sir, I am former international hockey player. I am one of the parent of the fencer in Hyderabad.
Great.
This is a good initiative taken by FAI and SAI sir. It's a good okay. initiative sir. Fencers को बहुत काफी मिलने को सीखने को मिल रहा है sir. बहुत अच्छा program किया है ने sir आप लोग उत्तराखंड में.
Thank you आपके comments matter to us. I hope that training of your kids will improve with this and I being a sportsman I thank you for logging in. We will come back to you. Bitisha Gohain.
Thank you sir.
Bitisha Gohain आप कहाँ के रहने वाले हैं please.
सर
यस यस
सर मैं तीनसुकिया डिस्ट्रिक्ट से हूँ.
तीनसुकिया से मैंने देखा है बहुत से लोग प्रैक्टिस कर रहे हैं, आपको कुछ इससे अगले 10 सेकंड में बताइए कुछ इससे फायदा हुआ आपको?
सर मुझे ये प्रोग्राम बहुत अच्छा लगा है, आप लोगों ने हम लोग के लिए इतना अच्छे से ये किया है और इसे हम लोगों को बहुत अच्छे से अच्छा सीखने के लिए मिला है और
थैंक यू विशिता, थैंक यू, स्टे टच, वी हैव लॉट मेनी पीपल. अनन्या बैनर्जी, यू आर फ्रॉम व्हिच प्लेस एंड हाउ इट हेल्प्ड यू?
गुड मॉर्निंग सर, आई एम फ्रॉम तिनसुकिया असम.
ओके
सर, मुझे बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है ये क्लास करके, बहुत कुछ सीखने मिला है, फिर डाउट्स भी क्लियर हो रहे हैं, बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है सर यहाँ पे.
थैंक यू. आई नेवर न्यू यू आर फ्रॉम तिनसुकिया, सो मेनी पीपल फ्रॉम तिनसुकिया. नाउ आई कम टू द हरदीप. हरदीप आप कहाँ के रहने वाले हैं और हाउ इट इज हेल्पिंग यू बताइए.
हेलो,
हाँ हाँ सुन रहे हैं आपको.
सर मैं पंजाब का रहने वाला हूँ और मेरे को बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है ये क्लास अटेंड करके, आप सारे वर्ल्ड के कोच को एक साथ लेके आए हो, नेपाल, श्रीलंका और पूरे इंडिया के. तो मैं एक बात बताना चाहता हूँ, जो हम सीख रहे हैं वो हम अपने फेंसर पे और अपने जो प्लेयर हैं उन पे अप्लाई करना चाहिए. जो आज हम लोहित भाई से सीख रहे हैं, जो आज मैंने बहुत कुछ नया सीखा फाइल फेंसिंग के बारे में, कन्वेंशन सीखी, वो आज जो बता रहे हैं.
हरदीप प्लीज, वी आर शॉर्ट ऑफ टाइम, आप प्लीज इंप्लीमेंट कीजिए और पंजाब ने बहुत अच्छे फेंसर प्रोड्यूस किए हैं, आप प्लीज और फेंसर प्रोड्यूस कीजिए. नो आई विल गो टू समबडी. अक्षय माने यू मस्ट बी फ्रॉम महाराष्ट्र, प्लीज नस्ट 10 सेकंड्स, हाउ इट इज बेनिफिटिंग यू? अक्षय माने,
हेलो
अक्षय माने, प्लीज टेल.
गुड मॉर्निंग सर.
यस गो अहेड.
हां बहुत सीखने को मिल रहा है सर, अच्छे टेक्नोलॉजी से मैं को फेंसिंग डेवलप करने का चांस मिला है और महाराष्ट्र के फेंसर को आगे जाके बहुत सारा उनको अच्छा आइडिया मिलने वाला है और उनको फेंसिंग में ज्यादा से ज्यादा नॉलेज मिल रहा है सबको और बच्चों को खेलने के लिए कॉन्फिडेंस आ रहा है.
थैंक यू वेरी मच. अपने आप को म्यूट कर लीजिए. नो आई विल गिव वन चांस टू समबडी, देन वी विल गो फॉर द नेक्स्ट सेशन एंड फॉलोड बाय अराउंड 11:20 वी विल कम बैक अगेन विद लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस. एक आई एम जस्ट लुकिंग फॉर अजय, इज देयर अजय? Ajay from Riyasi. I cannot see you. Krishanji, if you can see, you can unmute him. I need to mention about this guy. He has done a wonderful job.
No, sir. I think he is using some other name.
Ajay, you are there? Please raise your head. If you are not there, raise your hand. Okay, I think he is not there. Now, we have got another international fencer from Kerala. Risha, can you listen to me? Risha, you have been national champion. And great player we had. Next 20 seconds, please share. Risha.
Hello.
Risha is there. Risha, next 20 seconds. Welcome. You are one of the role model of all the fencers and coach of great repute. next 20 seconds. Please share your view.
Hello.
Yes, Risha.
ये क्लास चल रहे है, बहुत अच्छे से चल रहे है, सारा बच्चा लोग के लिए अच्छा है और कोच के लिए भी, नया कोच है सारे उनके लिए भी अच्छा अच्छा क्लास है ये।
थैंक यू रिशा, थैंक यू वेरी मच। मुझे पता है जब सागर वो वीडियोस दिखाता है, व्हेन द सागर वाज शोइंग वीडियो, द पार्टनर हु इज मेकिंग दोस वीडियोस इज यू एंड यू मे बी करेक्टिंग हिम इन ऑन लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स। थैंक यू वेरी मच रिशा, थैंक यू वेरी मच। Lohit, over to you. After that, we will around 11:25. We'll get some new people all there. Lohit, over to you, brother. I will unmute you. Krishanji, if you can unmute him.
Thank you, Vikram sir. Before we move on to the next conventions, which is point in line, so it goes to a complete different dimension. I would like to play a couple of videos. I understand some of the videos, we've got feedbacks that, some of them are using it on mobile and 2G signals are there. But I think if you watch this video, let me try my best to play a couple of videos about attack, counter-attack videos so that it will be very clear for you all to understand. So these are some of the videos that are basically attack, counter-attack. So the first three videos will be attack from the right, counter attack from the left, and then attack will be from the left. So the first three is attack from the right. So let me go on this. This was clearly attacked from the right, even though the fencer did a lunge from the left. This is also attacked from the right.
Lohit, videos are not played properly. There's a lot of pause in it. I would request if played.
Okay. So this is a longer video, which is in slow motion. This is attacked from the left. There's another view of it. Vikram sir, are the videos clear?
No, they are not clear. They are coming with a lot of pause in it. I would request you can keep saying and we can put this video on the Facebook later.
Okay, so before I move on to this point in line, I would also like to add on to what I've been talking about. So when you saw those videos, you clearly saw that fencer A was moving forward in steps, and then fencer B did a lunge, opening his hand, did a lunge, but at the same time even fencer A hit at the same time. There were two lights, but since fencer A had the right of way, fencer, and the right got the point. This is very similar action that you see in most of the videos on YouTube. Once you start moving forward, if it is a continuous movement without any pause, I think that is where the referee clearly sees your movements. So make sure that when you move forward, because a lot of people say when the fencer does drastic actions, trying to deflect the opponent's blade, trying to gain the right of way, doing affairs, doing beats on the opponent's blade, is also, people say it is preparation. But according to me, if the intention of the fencer is very important. So when a fencer is moving forward, he cannot just move, very still with his just hand back or, with just hand here, very still. He cannot just move very still and just go finish. He can, definitely, try to touch the opponent's blade, take beat priority. But if while executing his finishing, if he tries to find the opponent's blade, then that is preparation. So that is where the referee actually looks at, that is the difference between your right of way and your attacking and finishing. So you need to be very clear what is your preparation and what is your attack and what is the right of way. So if these three things are clear to you, I'm sure you can do wonders when you're refereeing in foil. And also in terms of coaching prospect, it will be very helpful for your you know, for you to teach your fences. So moving on, this is a very regular question that has been asked in all the classes, most of the classes for the referee. So I thought I will take some time to explain point in line. Well, you all know point in line is it is a special and a specific position in which a fencer's sidearm is kept straight and the point of his weapon is continuously threatening his opponent's valid target. So let's say there are two fencers, okay? The referee says, "On guard, dupre ale." If I extend, if fencer in the right, you know, fencer on my right extends the arm before the start of fencer B. So this is fencer A and this is fencer B. So if after ale, if I extend my arm straight, threatening the opponent's target. So the foil target area, you all know the foil target area, it has to be threatening the opponent's target area. If I open the hand, irrespective of this fencer comes and thrusts me, I will get the point. So with point in line, there are a few other questions that people ask. One is that when point in line, is it okay to move backside or, you know, have a lot of movements in point in line? But I would say once you open the hand, that means you have the right of way. You can either move forward or backward, but make sure that your arm is straight, it is not bent, and it is continuously threatening the opponent's target. So the first thing that you need to remember is the point in line starts before the opponent's attack. So that is the number one criteria to, you know, do a point in line. So the other situation is that while there are two fences fencing, moving backwards, if there is a fencer who breaks the distance and also opens the hand, that is also considered to be point in line because you are breaking the distance before the opponent starts a new attack. So what is break of distance? Well, it is basically out of distance. So breaking distance is out of distance. Any distance which is beyond step plunge distance is considered to be out of distance. So while moving back, if a fencer breaks the distance and also opens his arm threatening before the opponent starts, when there is ale, if you open the hand, that is a get, and then finish. So while finishing also, your arm should not be bent. So that is point in line for you all. Moving on is referee's attack. So this is another very frequently asked question. Sir, we do not understand what is referee's attack. So if I have to explain you in my own words, if fencer A starts an attack, that fencer A starts an attack and he finishes the attack. So let's say he starts with two step forward, he does a lunge. So fencer B goes two step back, but unfortunately he does not start his attack. So the moment fencer A finished this attack, he lost the right of way. So the right of way is transferred to fencer B. So when the fencer B has the right of way, he has to start his attack within one fencing time. So one fencing time was very clearly explained by Mohit sir, Sagar sir, Krishan sir, all those, you know, people who spoke to you. One fencing time is that fencing time that you execute one single action. You know? So when fencer A finishes the attack, when you have the right of way, if you do not start your attack immediately before the start of this attack, if this fencer starts a renewed account, you know, attack, if he either comes back to guard position or let's say he's in lunge and he starts moving forward with the lunge, so that is considered to be referee's attack. So this is very common nowadays. So this is basically used as against the convention because a lot of fencers have been playing with the convention. So these are some of the techniques that are used to, you know, that are against the conventions. So they try to, nowadays fencer try to, you know, immediately come with two step forward lunge and do a feint. They intentionally don't hit the opponent so that they can immediately start the referee's attack because they know that if they feel that this fencer B does not start the attack in one fencing time or if it's too late, then fencer A always starts on with the referee's attack. So that's referee's attack for you all. Moving on, you need to understand the signals because if you do not understand the referee signal, because there could be a referee who's explaining, you know, who could be telling the convention in French, but English or French, if you do not understand any of these languages, it is very important that you see what the action is. So all the actions that you see here, starting from on guard, the pre, that is readiness, play, ale, halt. So point in line, you see how it is shown. It is just action, just like the action that is performed. His arm is straight, so point in line. And how the referee shows attack, then how he shows if it is a parry repose or hit scored or if it is off the target. And then if it is a double hit, and then simultaneous, he says simultaneous and then double hit. Or if there is no action performed, it is nothing. And then it is attack no and premier no is the same action that the referee shows. And if it is incorrect action, so again, the referee, you know, tries to take a hand back, or if, you know, if the hand is up, you know, in terms of servers, but in foil, if it is an incorrect action, so again, you know, that is the action shown. Even for preparation, let's say if there is preparation from fencer A and attack from fencer B, so the referee says it is preparation, it is preparation from fencer A and attack from the fencer A. So that's how it is. Moving on, I would like to talk about the video referees. It is very important for you to know this, because this is the next future, and it is already being followed in all the international competitions. Very soon, I'm hoping that we will also start video referees in national level competitions. So it is very important that you know the rules and regulations of video referee. First and foremost thing is that to be a video referee at an international competition, you also need to have an FI license. It is not that anybody can do a video referee. You also have to be trained to assist the video, in terms of how to play the video, slow motion, fast motion. So there are different aspects to it. And you have to be a different, you need to be a different nationality than the fencer who are fencing. So that is very obvious. Same nationality are not allowed even in video refereeing. And you should also be from a different country from the main referee also, because they think the decisions might, you know, be favored, you know, so that is why, you know, they always feel that it is better to be of different nationality also. Moving on, in pool bout, you have one referee if there is a video referee facility, because even now some of the competition do not have video referee in pool bouts, but about 80 to 90% international competitions, yes, have video referees in pool bouts also. So in pool bouts, you have one referee if your decision is, if you are correct, then you move on. In direct elimination, there are two video referees you have, and if you are right, you retain it. And in team bout, you have one per bout. Okay, so I just want to quickly summarize on the P cards. Mr. Deepak has explained P cards absolutely. It was very clear, but I just have to recap. Some of the things, highlight few things. One is that in P cards, you have P yellow card followed by P red, again followed by P red, and then it is P black. And P black does not mean that you are excluded from the competition. These P cards are completely different from the other offenses, the red card, yellow card that we were talking about, starting slide. And these are again very important things when you should not give P cards. Okay, there are so many instances where Mr. Deepak explained you when to give P cards. It was very clear. So I thought I will pick out the point where, there are the situations you should not give P cards. One, if the scores are 14 all in direct elimination, and in team bouts, if it is 44 all, no P cards can be given. And there are no P cards in pool bouts, and there are no P card in the priority 1 minute. So after the time has been completed, you go on for the priority 1 minute after the toss. Even in that 1 minute, P cards are not used. Okay, so this is my last slide before we move on to the question answers. How to implement these things on what I told you. So three important points that I personally believe is it starts with self. If you start doing it, you can expect the others also to do it. So if you think something is wrong, and if some place is dirty, I think you have to put that effort to go there and clean it, or you have to put that effort to start doing it. So start with self, and then everybody else will start following it. The second thing is do it every day. Like fencing, it is like muscle memory. When you do it every day, you put it into habit about the things that I've told you, and then it becomes very easy for you to use it in the competitions or wherever it is. Third point is that you need to have an open mind and a positive approach. So when there is something new that has been taught, you will always have the readiness to learn something new. I always learn from the questions that you ask, because your question is making me go through the rule book every day, and I'm not finding these answers anywhere outside. So I must tell you, you need to follow the rule book. Rule book is like the Bible to all the referees, but all the answers that I'm giving you is in the rule book. It is not that I'm picking from somewhere outside. So make sure that you have a positive approach and learn from others. You always have, you know, a learning curve even from your students. So that is what I believe in. So before I conclude, we'll have question and answer session. And then
Lloyd, thank you very much. We will conclude at the end. There are so many things I have lined up with. If you think that you know all the answers, then let me tell you the questions I've got today. There are a lot of googlies in it. And especially a question from Santosh Pandey, my dear friend from Bengal. He always comes with very great and unexpected questions. But before that, I have to introduce 2-3 people to you today. हमने आप लोगों से थोड़े दिनों पहले कल एक क्वेश्चन पूछा था कि इंडिया में आज तक सबसे ज्यादा नेशनल चैंपियनशिप्स में मेडल किसने जीते हैं. इस अगेन मोस्ट ऑफ द कोचेज एंड प्लेयर दे डोंट नो कि मणिपुर हैज बीन ए पावर हाउस ऑफ इंडियन फेंसिंग सिंस यू कैन से the existence of fencing in this country. और मेरा हमेशा हारा हूं और शायद मैं फ्रॉम मणिपुर. मैगलम्बा एक वाहिद खिलाड़ी है और मेरा बहुत प्रिविलेज है और मेरे वर्किंग ही हैज हिज ओन क्लब. ये मणिपुर फेंसिंग की बहुत सी रीड सी हड्डी रीड की हड्डियां हैं, उनमें से मैगलम्बा एक है. हम इसको मैगलम्बा भैया और निक नेम इनको चाचा कहते थे क्योंकि इन्होंने बहुत सी चीजें इतना जीता हुआ है इन्होंने कि आई स्टार्टेड हेटिंग हिम लाइक यू नो लियानो मेसी. कितना जीतोगे यार, बाकियों को भी मौका देने दो. तो बहुत रिक्वेस्ट करके इनको हम आज ऑनलाइन लाए हैं. मैगलम्बा है, मणिपुर से है, फॉयल और सैबर के नेशनल चैंपियन रहे हैं ये लगातार 5-7-10 साल. आई डोंट नो मैगलम्बा चाचा, आपको 10-20 सेकेंड में बताइए. आपका बहुत बहुत स्वागत है. आप बहुत अच्छा काम कर रहे हैं फेंसिंग के लिए. अपने आप की अपनी भावनाओं को अपने इमोशंस को व्यक्त कीजिए. ओवर टू यू.
थैंक यू. मैं चैंपियनशिप में सभी टाइम्स चैंपियन किया था और नेशनल गेम्स में 5 टाइम्स नेशनल गेम.
क्या बात है.
नेशनल गेम्स इसका
आपकी आवाज थोड़ी कम आ रही है लोगों को. मैं ये बताना चाहता हूँ कि ही हैज बीन गोल्ड मेडलिस्ट इन 5 नेशनल गेम्स. ही हैज बीन नेशनल चैंपियन मोर देन 7 टाइम्स इन फॉयल एंड Saber, both individual event. और आया था, मैं आपको सैल्यूट करती हूँ. चरणजीत मैडम ने लिखा है ग्रेट टू सी यू मैगलम्बा सर. कईयों ने लिखा है आई कैन नॉट हेयर यू. रोशन मेतई ने लिखा ही इज माई टीचर, आई फील प्राउड फॉर यू. देर हैज बीन इंटरनेट प्रॉब्लम आई थिंक, दैट इज वाई आवाज नहीं आ रही है. और अगले 10 सेकंड में मैगलम्बा सर आप कुछ बता देंगे कि आपका अपना क्लब है और आप कितने फेंसर प्रोड्यूस कर चुके हैं अभी तक. सर 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 मैगलम्बा आवाज नहीं आ रही है. मैं लोगों को बता दूं, इन्होंने लगभग 550-600 से ऊपर फेंसर प्रोड्यूस किया है अभी तक. इनका एक क्लब है, ये बच्चों को फाइनेंशियली भी मदद करते हैं. such a wonderful to have you here. There is some problem with the internet, and we will try and get you again with better connectivity, Meghalamba sir, and preferably on last day. I want you to introduce to the many people on the last day. Thank you very much. Now I will get you to another coach of, in fact, he is my coach. He is a coach of Rashid and most of the people. He is father of Jammu Fencing. And 15 days he has been listening properly. I wanted to get Shotulal sir online. Krishanji, if you can unmute him. He was my guru. He got us into this game. Me, Rashid, Deepak and all those. He has produced, I think, more than 100 people in J&K who has been international. Can you
find
see
him? I think he has changed his screen name. Before he was there, but right now, I cannot find him.
You cannot find him. You are there, Shotulal sir? No, I don't think he's there. Okay. No, first question, I think there are many people I wanted to get online, but after we'll do it after question answer session. Lohit?
Yes.
Lohit, first question to you, and this question is from Pandey, Santosh Pandey from Bihar. Bengal. He says, isse pehle main aapko bata dun, I was telling you, Kartarpur is the place where fencing, hockey produced many Olympians. I was wrong. It was basically Sansarpur. And I correct myself, and thank you, Bisham, for this input. People like you are always there who support us in thick and thin. Thank you, Bisham. Now, Santosh Pandey has asked a question. What happens if one fencer fails a gender test? What will happen? You have come across something like that, a gender test.
Well, so far, I haven't come across the situation. I think this is, this is like something out of the earth question, not even out of the box.
Yeah.
So if there is somebody who can answer, then I can learn from that, question.
As little I know, you have to do a lot of hormonal and scientific tests, that too on a complaint or some medical which is being done for the athletes. Fencing, it has never happened, Santosh Pandeyji, but it is a very wonderful question. It can be covered under many offenses, code of integrity, sports act, then so many things, but it is a punishable offense. If you hide it deliberately, you will be punished. There have been some athletes previously who has been punished for that. No, we go to the next question. Lohit, it is a very simple question. People want to know how they should prepare for five referee exam.
Well, I would like to share my experience.
Rohit, just precise. I have got very questions and 20-30 seconds and people can contact you later.
The first and foremost thing is you need to be perfect with your conventions. You need to know how to explain your conventions, because that is what everybody is looking at. So when you go for appear for an exam, you will be given theoretical questions. Only if you clear the theoretical questions out of the 15 questions, you will be allowed to take up video examinations. So I would recommend you to read the rule book. Next, watch a lot of videos. Watch, when you watch the videos, do not just agree with the referee. Also, try to understand what the convention is. Try to explain on your own, okay, what has happened in that phase. And then try to go for practical. And then practice it. So these are the three different
things. Lohit, somebody has told me long time back, when you see the video, don't slow them and see. The convention completely changes. You should see them in one action, fast action, natural action. Don't slow it and try and judge it. It is right?
Well, yes. In most of the situations, it is when it comes to convention, it is always good to see in the real time. When there is any other offense that has been done, like say covering of target or moving out of lateral boundaries, some of these things, then I think you can also slow down and watch. But I would also recommend watch it in real time. It gives you the clear conventions on who's starting first, who has the right of it.
Thank you. Thank you. Lohit, another question is that for you. First, I'll finish the question with you. Then I'll go to the other panelist. This is a very wonderful question sent by Prabhu. Even I am also slightly doubtful on that. He says, any two yellow cards in a bout can make a red, or two similar offense yellow cards can make it a red?
Well, this is the confusion that a lot of people have with the cards. Well, first is the yellow card and then the red card. So it is nothing called two yellow cards. There is nowhere there is two yellow cards. So first offense, so first time you make a mistake, a minor error, and you get a yellow card. You repeat the same mistake, you get a red card. There is no one more yellow card to it.
Okay. So Lohit, you mean to say you cannot segregate cards as per the offense. Somebody who has used, for example, yellow card for every offense, two yellow cards, it will become a red. Milkes, first yellow, then red. No, it is not this offense specific.
Yes.
Okay. Well, yes. Now, yeah, please.
I was agreeing to what you said, because the first time you make a minor offense, it is yellow card. It moves on to red directly, so there is no other warning given to you.
Okay, now another question for you, Lohit. You know something about the publicity code and what are the offenses, although it is not a technical, for referee point of view, it is more to the publicity commission of this. You know about some publicity code?
Well, I do not know 100% of it. Well, I would like to tell you what I know. Publicity code is about the advertisements, you know, certain fences, you know, try to brand on their, you know, jacket or mask, you know, it happens. So there is a particular, you know, size that is given or a place that is given that you can exhibit, you know, your sponsors. So there are certain rules to it.
Okay.
Which I'm not.
Lohit, I just want to add on to this. Simple si bhasha mein, publicity code has got lot of litigations in it. Suppose when you once you get a sponsorship of a particular brand, in that, to the best of my knowledge, it is also written in that ki that you cannot advertisement other products of similar specifications. For example, agar All Star ne aapko sponsor kiya hai, to aap PBT ka equipment नहीं कर सकते. क्रिकेट में जनरली होता है ये कि दोज हु आर स्पॉन्सर्ड बाय कोका कोला दे कैन नॉट एडवर्टाइज फॉर द पेप्सी. दिस इज वन विजन बट दिस इज अ वंडरफुल क्वेश्चन. वी विल ट्राई एंड गेट सम एक्सपर्ट ऑन दिस इन द फ्यूचर टू कम. लोहित, अनदर क्वेश्चन, हाउ कैन वी नो अपोनेंट जैकेट इज स्मॉल?
सॉरी,
अपोनेंट फॉइल जैकेट. How one can see it that the size of the jacket is not good or it is a small? What portion you can see it or wear it?
Well, there is first and foremost thing is the shoulder bone that you have. It cannot be under your shoulder bone. So it has to be exactly to your shoulder bone. So this is where you first check the size here. And then moving down, when you do a lunge, it should not be above your hip level,
okay,
your waist. So, you know, the referee asks you to perform a lunge, and that's where he checks. Even by performing lunge, if the jacket moves beyond your waist up, then, you know, it will not be applicable. So it has to be, you know, below your waist there, right there.
Les, Lohit, there are so many questions regarding conventions. I think once people go through your PPT and videos, they will answer that. I have got one more question for you. Somebody is saying that some fencer deliberately leaves the weapon or keeps throwing the weapon during the bout. What grade of offense it is and how referee can handle it?
Well, throwing of weapon comes under the first group of offense. So you will be penalized with the yellow card, which is a minor warning. And then next time you repeat the same thing, you will be given a red card. So throwing of weapon is the first group of offense.
Okay, and what is the difference? Tukaram has asked this question. What is the difference between foil preparation and saber preparation?
This is a beautiful question. Well, I was about to tell you that I'm going to answer Tukaram's question here, because this is where a lot of people get confused. A lot of people think it is foil and saber are similar. Well, there are a few differences, and these differences actually make a lot of difference. Well, I must tell you, in saber, in the 4 meters, on guard, when referee says on guard, dupre ale, referee sees start and also the finishing. The finishing of hand is very important. But in foil, let's say when somebody has the right of way, when somebody starts with the step forward and somebody does a lunge and then he also hits at the same time, then fencer A has the right of way since it's a thrusting weapon. So this is the major difference. In saber, what happens is even though fencer A starts with the step, if he does not finish and fencer B finishes in one fencing time, and that becomes preparation and attack from the left. So this is one of the main difference. I will also tell you the second difference. The second difference is that if you hit with your foot landing at the same time, it is not attack premier no in foil. In saber, it is attack premier no. So these are like very important main things between saber and foil.
Thank you, Lohit. No, I will go to the Krishanji. I would request you unmute Rashid, Deepak, Rajiv Goldi. Three people, then I'll come to the other panelists. We have a time around 10-15 minutes with us. Rashid, you are there?
Yes, I am there.
Rashid, there is one question for you, specifically meant for you. I think some saber fencer sent me in person and he wrote your name also. That is why I wanted to give you this question. He said fencer X attacks and scores a valid touch. While attempting a parry, the fencer Y breaks his blade and could not register. कहने का मतलब ये है कि A fencer ने attack किया, दूसरे ने parry की, पर वो riposte नहीं कर पाया और दूसरे वाले का remise hit हो गया. तो क्या जब blade टूटता है, bout stops there or it continues?
इसमें वेरी क्लियर रूल है कि अगर आपका ब्लेड जो है वो ड्यूरिंग द एक्शन टूटता है तो वो हिट जो है वो अनाल होता है, वो किसी का हिट नहीं है. लेकिन अगर बहुत क्लियरली एक्शन है और ब्लेड आपका उसके आफ्टर बाद में टूटता है, क्लियर एक्शन करने के बाद, फिर जो हिट है वो वैलिड हिट है.
और दूसरा क्वेश्चन आपके लिए, उसके बाद में दीपक के पास आऊंगा, एपी स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चन है वो, कि साइबर रेफरी और फॉइल रेफरी में क्या डिफरेंस है, अगर आप दो या तीन लाइनों में बता दें तो. What as a referee, what is the difference? I think he has gone offline. Rashid? Deepak, you are there? Lohit, you can, Deepak, Lohit, you, Lohit, Rashid, haan, aap aage line pe?
Haan, ji, ji.
ये फॉइल रेफरी और सेबल रेफरी में, रेफरी जब आप करते हैं रेफरीशिप, व्हाट इज द मेन थिंग यू लुक एंड क्या डिफरेंस क्या है इसमें, एक दो लाइन में अगर बोल दें.
इसमें जो, जैसे लोहित ने बहुत बड़ी अच्छी तरह डिस्क्राइब किया है, स्पेशली जो अटैक प्रिपरेशन और जो डायरेक्ट अटैक है, इसके में इसमें साइबर में और फाइल में डिफरेंस है. साइबर में हम लोग जो आर्म के एक्शंस हैं और लॉन्चेस के एक्शंस हैं उनको बहुत प्रायोरिटी देते हैं, बट इन सम केसेस इन फाइल उसमें जो है जो कुछ प्रायोरिटी जो है वो स्टार्ट के साथ होती है. तो मोस्टली इसमें यही जो है वो देखा जाता है. जी,
थैंक यू रशीद. दीपक, यू आर देयर? I think I cannot unmute you. Deepak? Okay, it is. Deepak is not there, I think. Rajiv Goldi? Rajiv Goldi? He's there?
Rajiv is not there, but someone, I think his daughter is there, Navisha Bhardwaj. So I can unmute her.
I think Rajiv, if it Rajiv is not there, because there is a question for that. Okay, you can get Rajiv is there. Okay, he's there. He has come.
Sir.
Rajiv, अगले आप, अगर आप कुछ ऐड करना चाहें, because आप भी फाइल के रेफरी हैं, अगले 30 सेकंड्स में जो कुछ ऐड करना चाहें, फिर मैं I will go to the other panelist.
हाँ जी सर, thank you so much Mr. Vikram जी. वैसे तो I'm really thankful to Mr. Lohit. इन्होंने काफी कुछ क्लियर कर दिया वैसे. And there was one question हर कोई पूछा, जो पी रेफरी कार्ड्स हैं, जो पी, क्या वो खाली ईपी में ही हैं या साइबर और फॉइल में भी हैं? इट वाज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन आस्क्ड बाय वन ऑफ द चाइनीज फेंसर ड्यूरिंग आर इंटरनेशनल रेफरी एग्जाम. और आंसर गिवन बाय मिस्टर मेदाद सर, दैट वाज यस, कि यदि फॉइल में इफ टू प्लेयर्स आर वॉलंटरी नॉट प्लेइंग, नॉट पार्टिसिपेटिंग, देन रेफरी हैज दैट राइट टू शो दैट पेनल्टी कार्ड एंड दैट विल बी ट्रीटेड एज पी in foil, but not in cyber because there is no timing. So I would like to mention this also in foil also, ki there is also P referee in foil only in some situations, but there is no mentions anywhere. This is only for EP.
अच्छा राजीव जी, अगला क्वेश्चन आपको ये बताता हूँ मैं, मेरे को बताइए कि आपने भी रेफरी टेस्ट क्लियर किया है, जब आप रेफरी टेस्ट के लिए जाते हैं तो आपसे जो टेस्ट प्लेयर होते हैं वो क्या एक्सपेक्ट करते हैं आपसे?
द मोस्ट प्रॉब्लम, सबसे पहली चीज है कि नॉलेज ऑफ गेम्स, सबसे पहले आपको नॉलेज, गेम की नॉलेज. एंड मिस्टर लोहित ने जो मेंशन किया कि आपको कन्वेंशन की नॉलेज होनी चाहिए, एक बड़ा अच्छा आंसर आपको, व्हेन यू हैव नॉलेज अबाउट कन्वेंशन देन नो नीड टू वरी अबाउट द कंपटीशन. आपको जब कन्वेंशन क्लियर है, वो सबसे पहले आपकी बॉडी लैंग्वेज, आपकी एक्शंस और आपकी कन्वेंशन चेक करते हैं. एक बड़ा अच्छा आंसर दिया था एक अच्छे रेफरी ने वर्ल्ड चैंपियनशिप में, उन्होंने दिखाई थी उसकी वीडियो, पूरी ऑडियंस जब देख रही होती है तो वो आपको सुन नहीं पाती, वो सिर्फ आपके एक्शन देखती है. व्हेन यू आर सिंपली डूइंग वन टू एंड थ्री, इट मींस कि वेरी क्लियरली पैरी रिपोस्टे हुआ है. पर यदि आप खाली बोल देते हो और एक्शन नहीं करते हो तो आपकी सारी चीजें क्लियर नहीं होती है. तो एक्शन स्पीक्स लाउडर देन वर्ड्स, आपकी कन्वेंशन और आपकी एक्शन और आपकी नॉलेज तीनों एक ही टाइम में बोलती है. तो यू शुड हैव गुड एक्सपीरियंस एंड नॉलेज ऑफ ऑल कन्वेंशन.
थैंक यू राजीव. यू कैन म्यूट योर सेल्फ. दीपक, यू आर देयर? दीपक, Deepak, hello. Deepak, you are there? I think he is not there, coach. He is not there. Krishan?
He's there, but I'm not able to unmute him.
If you can unmute Mohit ji, Ashok ji, and Sagar, I would like to have a comment from them also for 20 seconds each. Then I will go to the people I want to highlight.
Mohit sir is unmuted now.
Mohit sir, thank you very much for such a patient listener. Aap please kuch add on karein sir, isme you have a wonderful experience of 20 or 30 odd years. Please, over to you.
Good morning sir. Good morning sir. Am I audible?
Haan ji, very much, very much.
Achha, kya question kya tha? What was the question?
Sir, aap kuch bhi isme you add on jo aapne dekha hai, something which has been missed, aap please usme kuch add on kar lijiye agle 30 seconds.
Maine ek cheez dekhi thi, Lohit ke jo presentation thi, it was very good. बट मैं उसमें एक एड ऑन ये करना चाहता हूँ कि जैसे रोहित जी ने कहा था, एज ही सेड दैट टू येलो कार्ड्स आर नॉट पॉसिबल, बट अभी वो पॉसिबल हैं बिकॉज व्हेन इट इज इंडिविजुअल और टीम डायरेक्ट, इट इज डायरेक्ट एलिमिनेशन इन इंडिविजुअल एंड टीम मैच, तो जो नॉन कॉम्पिटिटिव या पैसिविटिव का जो है वो एक येलो कार्ड अगर मिलता है और दूसरा येलो कार्ड अगर टर्निंग द बैक फॉर एग्जाम्पल है तो वो दोनों येलो ही रहेंगे, रेड नहीं होंगे. यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम सेइंग? रेड तभी होंगे जब वो या तो पैसिविटी का दोबारा कोई ऑफेंस करे, यानी एक मिनट तक दोबारा कोई स्कोर ना हो, या वन मिनट नो बाउट एंड देन रेफरी अगेन गिव्स अ कार्ड एंड इट इज रेड, और या फिर वो और कोई ऑफेंस करे कि टर्निंग बैक के अलावा या कुछ वही या कुछ और ऑफेंस करे, तो तब दैट विल कन्वर्ट इन टू रेड कार्ड. सो नाउ सिचुएशन में दो कार्ड हो सकते हैं येलो का.
थैंक यू सर. सागर ओवर टू यू. सागर ओवर टू यू प्लीज.
विक्रम थैंक यू वेरी मच. सो बेसिकली जो लोहित ने बताया कि फॉइल साइबर में जो बेसिक डिफरेंस है, उसमें और एक डिफरेंस ये भी है कि फॉइल में हम लोग स्टैम्स अलाउड है, जो हम प्रिपरेशन करते हैं उसमें स्टैम के साथ अगर अटैक करते तो अलाउड है. वही सेम साइबर में स्टैम्स अलाउड नहीं है, क्योंकि साइबर में अगर आप स्टैम करते हो तो आपको बेसिकली वो अटैक प्रीमियर नो करके काउंट होता है. सेम वे हमारे को क्रॉसवर्ड मूवमेंट भी साइबर में अलाउड नहीं है. अगर हम फॉइल में प्रिपरेशन में अगर क्रॉसवर्ड मूवमेंट के साथ भी प्रिपेयर करते हैं तो दैट इज वैलिड अटैक और दैट इज वैलिड प्रिपरेशन. बट सेम वे में अगर आप साइबर में क्रॉसवर्ड मूवमेंट के साथ अगर आप कोई अटैक प्रिपेयर करते हो तो वो आपको पेनल्टी है, येलो कार्ड. फर्स्ट ग्रुप ऑफ ऑफेंस में आता है वो, इट विल बी कंपनाइज विद द येलो कार्ड. सो देयर आर सम डिफरेंसेस व्हिच हैव विद साइबर एंड.
Thank you, Sagar. This is such an add-on. Lohit, I would request you can later take on that. Ashok, is there Ashok Khatri ji? No.
Yes, I'm here. Yes.
Sir, please, sir, another 30 seconds. You can also add on something, then I'll go to players and coaches.
There was a question about publicity code.
Yes.
Let me say something. There is mask. On the mask, one mark is, you can go for one logo. You can say okay. On the back of the spring, and for jacket also one mark, for jacket, for breeches also one mark, for breeches and jacket it is 4.5 centimeter I think, and 2 centimeter into multiply for both jacket and breeches also one mark, and stockings also one mark is allowed for the stockings, same size, similar size, and on the shoes a brand name on the both, it means two marks, one on each foot. Gloves, okay. Glove pe koi mark nahi hota hai, aur weapon pe bhi dur se visible koi mark nahi hona chahiye. Aur iske alawa ye apni fencing ki thi, iske alawa agar you wanna wear ek jaisa track suit de dete hai na team ko kai baar. जो अगर वो पहनते हैं तो उसपे मुझे पता है कि 10x10 सेंटीमीटर का लोगो बना सकते हैं एक कोई स्पॉन्सर का. ओके 10x10 सेंटीमीटर का मास्क.
थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू सर. सर आई एम जस्ट शॉर्ट ऑफ टाइम. आप नो आई कुड नॉट एक्सपेक्ट समबडी बेटर देन यू आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन. नो आई विल गो टू द अजय कुमार फ्रॉम आई वांट टू गिव चांस टू फ्यू पीपल हु हैव बीन डूइंग वंडरफुल जॉब. अजय यू आर देयर?
यस आई एम हियर.
Okay, Ajay is one of the coaches, ex-national fencer. He works in a place called Riyasi. Riyasi is a place which is between Jammu and Kashmir, a kind of a remote area. Ajay ne bahut se fencer produce kiye hain wahan se as a coach. Aur Ajay ki sabse badi achievement ye hai ki inhone koi ek-ded saal pehle, he made a wonderful video about the fencing. sponsors requesting All Star to sponsor them with some equipment. इनके वीडियो को देख के All Star give them a gift voucher of $2,000 if I am right. अजय अगले 20 सेकंड में आप बताइए कि आपके पास कितने प्लेयर हैं, आपने ये आपको क्या बेनिफिट है और इसको कुछ मिल रहा है नहीं मिल रहा. आई वॉन्टेड टू हाईलाइट ओवर टू यू अजय.
ओके थैंक यू. सबसे पहले तो मैं ये बताना चाहूंगा कि अभी प्रेजेंटली जो मेरे पास हैं अराउंड 50 फेंसर्स जो ट्रेनिंग कर रहे हैं. और जहां तक बात है, सबसे पहले तो मैं अपने फेंसिंग फेडरेशन ऑफ इंडिया और साई की उनको थैंक्स बोलना चाहूंगा कि उन्होंने ये इतना अच्छा वंडरफुल प्रोग्राम जो है वो ऑर्गेनाइज किया. क्योंकि मैंने इतना ज्यादा खेला नहीं है नेशनल लेवल पे, 5 ही नेशनल्स खेले हैं और मैं रेगुलरली जम्मू कश्मीर टीम के साथ नेशनल्स में जाता रहता हूँ ताकि मैं अपने नॉलेज को अपडेट करता रहूँ. और उसके साथ साथ ये जो प्रोग्राम आप लोगों ने ऑर्गेनाइज किया, इससे हमें बहुत ही ज्यादा हेल्प मिल रही है ताकि हम वो चीज जो प्रैक्टिकली इंप्लीमेंट कर पाएं. जैसे कि आप जानते हैं कि मैं हायर एजुकेशन में असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर भी हूं और इन दोनों चीज़ों को मैनेज करना मेरे लिए इतना आसान नहीं रहता है. तो इस तरीके के जो प्रोग्राम्स हैं वो हमारे लिए बहुत ही अच्छे हैं जिससे हम अपने नॉलेज को अपडेट कर पाएं. और मैं ये रिक्वेस्ट करना चाहूँगा कि ये लॉकडाउन बंद होने तक के बाद इसको बंद नहीं कर देना चाहिए, कोई हफ्ते में एक दिन रख लेना चाहिए जिससे.
Keep doing the good work. आप अपने आप को म्यूट कर लीजिए. नो आई विल गो टू अनदर. वेरी गुड, थैंक यू वेरी मच. भूपिंदर सिंह फ्रॉम एमपी. आई डोंट थिंक ही इज देयर. आई एम नॉट एबल टू सी दैट. आई विल गेट सम अदर पीपल. आई वांट टू गिव चांस. लोहित, आई टेक अनदर 2-3 मिनट, देन यू कंक्लूड भाई. ओके, आई जस्ट वांट टू टेक 2-3 मिनट्स. आई वांट टू गेट सम गुड पीपल. प्लीज म्यूट योरसेल्फ. हू इज देयर? I will come to, just me, let me see. I am finding the people. I am not. Chotulal sir is there? Krishan ji, you could find him? No.
No sir, no.
Achha, he came and must be internet problem is there. No, I can get to the Ragin Maria. You are from which place?
Hello sir.
Yes, go ahead.
Hello sir, I am from Kerala. I am a student of Sagar sir.
Great.
First of all, thank to Fencing Association of India and this Sai to be know more about fencing, and to Lohit sir, Sagar sir, other all coaches to give more more details about fencing. Thank you sir.
Thank you. Just mute yourself. No, I'll go to. I'm just finding, trying to find the people. I'm not able to get many of them, but I will give chance to. Ajay Shori, please.
Hello.
Ajay Shori.
Thank you.
Where are you working as a fencing?
Yeah, right now I'm Royal Sports Academy, Alwar. Hello. I'm audible? Hello.
Anjanji Shori ji, you're audible. You can continue.
Yes. And sir, right now I'm Royal Sports Fencing Academy, Alwar. I'm coaching. Kar raha hu. और आज भैया ने मेरे से बात भी की थी हरप्रीत को लाने के लिए. मैंने उसको कॉल किया और भैया के साथ हम उसको यहाँ पे आज लाने के लिए क्या पाए. थैंक यू सर सो मच.
हेलो लोहित, ओवर टू यू फॉर कंक्लूजन ब्रदर.
ऑलराइट, थैंक यू मिस्टर विक्रम. वेल, आई वुड लाइक टू कंक्लूड बाय सेइंग thank you to the opportunity given to me. I would like to thank Sports Authority of India and Fencing Association of India, who've been doing this tremendous work during this lockdown period. I think you cannot ask anything more than this when you're sitting at home. Apart from that, I would also like to thank all the panelists who have been so generous and modest in having me, you know, in their panel. Because these panelists, I think in the next few years will be in the Hall of Fame. So to have me, along with them as a panelist, I think it is a very good thing. It is a big motivation for the young referees or coaches who are upcoming. Looking at this, I think a lot of people would, take up refereeing, because I always felt that foil has always been the least performing event compared to saber and epee. The main reason being is, the conventions are not very clear. So that is why I took this effort to, go for the referee test and understand, and thought I will make it clear.
And I'm very happy to see that there are many young coaches now, and they are working in their academies, and Foil is just picking up. If you see the way sub juniors and cadet Foil fencers are fencing, I think they can explain better conventions. So I think we have a new generation that is coming up with better convention knowledge, and all the other coaches are also updating every day. I would
thank you, Lohit. Thank you. I would like to. I have got just 2 minutes left.
And Vikram, sir, I just have one thing to say.
Yeah, yeah.
Well,
yeah.
I think everybody would agree. I think if there is a day when you retire from the army, I think you have a very good offer in the news channels. So it is, take it as a compliment. I think all the panelists will agree to it. Well, if you all agree, then you can type yes or send it in the group. So.
Thank you, Lohit. You are one of the best minds of fencing in India we have. And you are doing justice to it.
Thank you very much for a wonderful session. Now,
I just want to tell you something. Tomorrow we have a very wonderful class. A class which will be class apart for you. Just a minute. You are one of the. Hello, I'm audible now.
Yes, sir.
Lohit, tomorrow we have got a very wonderful class on. Tactical view of foil fencing by one of the best athletes of Greece. Mr. Rajiv Mehta approached the international FIE and told them to suggest something to us for this program. They recommended three coaches. Two of them are giving a session. One is on 5th, other one is on 12th, EP and foil. We are trying to get a saber also. Please attend in maximum strength, 10 o'clock. Request, send your questions on the WhatsApp community so that I can send him. We have got a class on periodization on 14th. Please go and ask questions. He's one of the best speakers. You will learn if you want to learn. Periodization is something which is missing very badly. Only very few people know, and that too up to some extent. Lohit, there is a compliment for you from Utsavi, another very young and bubbly fencer from Jharkhand. She said, "Ki sir, the wallpaper which you are using on laptop is amazing. If you can share that, please do that." Now we have many people I wanted to thank. I wanted to get many people. I don't have a time. I just want to conclude by saying there's a very beautiful saying somebody has told: you haven't taught until they have learned. Sabhi coaches ke liye, you have not taught until they have learned. Aapne tab tak sikhaya nahi hai jab tak unhone sikha nahi hai. This is the tagline you should have in your club. Think from fencer's point of view. There's amazing sessions coming up. You are such a wonderful audience. Very disciplined. Our program is in fact the best program being run by Sai, all because of your positivity. I would request all of you, if you have got some senior fencers from Kerala, those who have contributed and they are running academies, please get them. Stay safe. Take care. Adhere to the government policies. Make notes. This is a wonderful session. No, we will get